Lay out as each one of us and hope we have a wonderful Sabbath day in the grace of Jesus Christ. Starting my sermon, I want to share what the Pastor Pong, who attended last week from Samyuk University. Do you remember that? He stand by me in the back last week. And he shared his feeling of our church. I want to share that one. He told me that, "Pastor Daniel, I'm so happy to be here to worship in this Sabbath day. The church in heaven, would be like your church." Amen. And I asked, "Can you tell me why you think like that?" I wonder why. He said, "I'm sure that when we go to heaven, Jesus Christ should be the church pastor who are welcoming at the door, like, right? And when we step in the church hall, when we step in the chapel, we might hear joyful and loud voice of praises by church members like your church."
Amen.
And then, we will notice that after that, the church members comes from all of the different countries: Filipino, Indian, Chinese, Indonesian, African, Singaporean, Korean, American, European, and Japanese. And he said, "I guess woman must be more than men." So that is why I felt your church is like the church of heaven. And he suggests me and he commands me, "Daniel, you have to tell your church members about this more often and make them be proud of experiencing heavenly atmosphere here in the church."
Amen.
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 I'm proud of this church. I'm proud of you. And I'm proud of the special music. I'm proud of your loud voice. I'm proud of your passionate passions. This is the really light church in heaven. I start my sermon. Whenever I turn on the TV to watch the news show, I feel like the strong leaders of the big countries are playing a power game to get more benefit for their countries. You know, the Donald Trump, USA president, and Xi Jinping, General Secretary of China, and Shinzo Abe, Prime Minister of Japan, and Kim Jong-un, the Chairman of North Korea. It was a dangerous big match under extremely high tension between countries. North Korea threatened the world by launching a missile which is able to carry a nuclear bomb. It is like saying, "Don't touch me, don't touch my country, I will do whatever I want." In this situation, the president of Korea, South Korea, was changed. Because I watch the Korean TV, Korean news, so understand me, I'm telling you the Korean news. The President Moon dealt with this urgent matter immediately on his first day of the work as the President of Korea. Do you know what did he do first? He he sent special envoy. He sent ambassador to the countries, ambassador to USA, ambassador to Japan, ambassador to China, delivered the messages of new president of Korea. As a result, he stepped forward to solve this problem based on the trustworthy relationship between them. The result was very positive. I want to talk about an ambassador today. Because surprisingly, the Bible tells us we are ambassador for Christ. Let's open the Bible. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 18 to 21. Oh, I'm sorry. This is 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 18 to 21. Let's read it together. Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation, that is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of reconciliations. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Amen?
Amen.
The Bible tells us, we are ambassador for Christ. Do you know who is ambassador? Do you know what they do? Do you know how can they carry out their mission well? The ambassador is an accredited diplomat sent by the head of country as a representative in foreign country. They speak to them on behalf of their country, build a good relationship, and cooperate with them to have more benefit for each other. This is the ambassador. This is the ambassador. I read a book which is written by Korean diplomat. The book's name, book called A Diplomat Must Be a Multiplier. She mentioned about a letter of credence. The letter of credence is a kind of certificate to the country. The letter of credence for the ambassador in his book. It is written like this. I translated it so that it might be, not smooth. The government of Korea appoints Daniel as an ambassador extraordinary and planning potentially between two countries. His word have same authority with my words in your country. I hope that you will support him to establish a long-lasting relationship between you and me. How's it feel like? Is his responsibility heavy or light? What do you think? Yeah, it's really heavy. His word, his behavior is a represent of country, right? Our words. Are you using bad word? Oh, our behaviors represent of our country, represent of our country in heaven. Is it really heavy, right? Very important. This is a big responsibility to be able to build up or ruin the relationship between two countries. His word will be regarded as the word of his country. His behaviors will be regarded as the attitude of his country. Because of this reason, he cannot speak and he cannot behave carelessly. To live a Christian life means to live as an ambassador for Christ and a representative of a heavenly kingdom. It could have heavy responsibility to us. If we are willing to do our work carefully as a representative of heaven, we will be blessed a lot. A few years ago, a Korean ambassador to Chile committed adultery. Wow. I was so embarrassed. It was broadcasted on the TV and became a big issue in the country of Chile. It made me and all Koreans embarrassed about it. And the president of Korea apologized to the people of Chile. On the contrary, let's think about the apology. Good example. The Olympic Games was held in Rio last year, right? 2016, Rio Olympic. Of course, they are not an ambassador, but they are national representative in sports field. To win the medal in the sports, judo and wrestling, races and archery and soccer and every sports match, they tried to their best. To tell the truth, for 4 years, the Olympic Games, for 4 years, they have controlled all their desires to win the medal. They cannot eat as much as they want to control their weight. They have to train and practice very hard every day, and they push themselves to overcome their weak point and improve their skill to win the games. To attach the national flag on the chest is not easy and have a heavy responsibility because they are a representative of the nations. If they win the gold medal, it is not only their glory, but also the glory of the country. As we carry out our responsibility as an ambassador of heavenly kingdom, greatly the prize and reward cannot compare with the gold medal. It would never be a small thing. How can we carry out the duty of an ambassador for Christ successfully? First of all, the Bible tells us that we have to be reconciled to God. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 20-21. Be reconciled to God, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. We have to be reconciled to God. In order to reconcile to God, we have to solve the problem of the sin. Isaiah chapter 59, verse 1. Let's read it together.
Your
iniquities have separated you from your God. This is the problem. This is the problem. Sin make our relationship broke. Sin is the biggest issue, which is spoiling the relationship between God and us. However, we cannot find a solution for this problem in us. We cannot remove our sinful nature by ourselves. Only the blood of Jesus Christ can cleanse our transgressions. Only Jesus Christ can ransom our debt of our sin by sacrificing on the cross. I want to share a story of my friends. He's my good friends. This happened when he entered the Korean army. All the men have a duty for the army service. And around 20 to 21, 22 years old, around that time, we have to conduct that duty in the army. And in the big ground, we say goodbye to the parents. And the instructors led us, lead us to the camp of the soldiers. And he also said goodbye to parents. And then the instructors brought him to the corner of the building, and the instructor's face totally changed. And then before that, they smiling, and then he didn't say goodbye. And then on the corner of the building, he changed face. Are you nervous? Are you playing? This is not a game. My bad. It's strict and frightened. They gave training soldiers severe disciplines with the harsh words to make them under their control. They didn't allow even a small mistake, like needed to walk in the same boat, with the same boat. And if one of them step other foot and stop, everybody, now push up 10 times like that. It was so strict. And they didn't allow even a small mistake. If they sound a small voice, then that is another reason to be punished. It was so severe. It was so harsh. And all the training soldiers exhausted. Instructors gave push-up a lot of time and crawling forward and backward and frog jumping over 100 times until they exhausted. At this time, one of the training soldiers spoke a bad word in a small voice, unconsciously, XXX. Unfortunately, one of the instructors heard it, but didn't notice who spoke it. He got mad. He let soldiers make push-up postures and yelled to them, "Confront the soldier who spoke bad word." The soldier who spoke, he was afraid of the punishment. He couldn't go front. The instructor gave all of them more strict disciplines, and it was getting worse and worse. And my friends couldn't stand the unrighteous torturing of innocent soldiers to find out a lone person. He stand up and he's saying, "I did, sir. That's my fault, sir. I apologize, sir." The instructor called him front and let him make push-up posture and beat his thigh with a long stick 20 times, very strongly. How painful it was. He endured that punishment. His thigh was swallowed and he couldn't walk naturally for a while because of severe pain. And guess what happened next in his platoon's army? The one who spoke bad words confessed his wrong deed to his colleague, Franklin. And he apologized to him and all the soldiers in platoon. And my friends became a hero in the platoon because of his sacrificial behaviors. And after that, he can tell the gospel easily to others and keep the Sabbath day in the army. Amen? Like my friends, Jesus Christ paid our ransom of death penalty. He took our place on the cross and died instead of us. His heroic deed opened the way of life and changed our destiny. And we confess our sin, turn around from our wrong direction, we can be reconciled to God. We can work as an ambassador for Christ. Secondly, we needed to do the ministry of reconciliation. We needed to do the ministry of reconciliation. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 18. God gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Before that, now all these are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. God has given us the ministry of reconciliation. As an ambassador, the relationship with others is very important to carry out our mission. Otherwise, their message might be misunderstood and small problems could be a big issue. We experience many conflict in our life, in our working place, in our church, in our families. In most of the case, tiny conflicting issues causes a big trouble. It breaks our good relationship, a good atmosphere, and became worse and worse. How can we reconcile with others? How can we recover from that relationship? The answer is forgiveness. The answer is forgiveness. Jesus Christ answered Peter when he asked how many times I should forgive, up to 7 times. I do not say to you, Jesus Christ said, up to 7 times, but up to 70 times 7. Matthew chapter 18 verse 22. And Colossians chapter 3 verse 13, I didn't put it here. Colossians chapter 3 verse 13. Bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. Once again, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. I read a story about a man, Kim Yong-jae. He is a murderer. In 1991, his age was 21 years old. He was full of anger against the society. He drove a car and entered into a park square where a lot of people enjoyed their times without reducing speed. He drove crazy the car. He crashed many people and they were injured and killed. One of the old women saw Yunbom, who brought her 6 years old grandson, lost him in the park at this time. Even though she was a sincere Christian, she couldn't bear anger and sorrow, and she complained to God in prayer, like, God, how dare you deal with me like this? How come you take away my precious grandson? Why did you allow this happening? She cried and cried and cried. And she was exhausted and fell down on the ground. She heard a voice in silence. Forgive him. And she felt like, what? The voice became more clear and louder. Forgive him. Forgive him. She doubted her ears and thought that it is not possible, Lord. However, she decided to meet this terrible murderer. She met him at the court on the day he got a death sentence. And she noticed that he was born in a poor family. He had a handicap. His one eyesight was almost blinded. His mom left her home, and his father killed himself when he was a child. He was always alone in school. He failed to have a job many times because of his handicap. Because of these reasons, he was full of anger against the cold and unfair society. He was shivering in fear when he got the death sentence. The old woman felt pity on him, and she approached and grabbed his hands and embraced him tightly, saying, I forgive you. Exchanging letters, and she got to know more about him, and amazingly, she adopted him as her son. Wow. And visited his prison every week to give a special food and read the Bible. This love made him change. He became Christian and donated his organs. And she pleaded to the court his reduction of penalty, but it is rejected. December in 1997, after 6 years, he put to death after all. His last word was so meaningful to us. Thankfully, I was forgiven. I was forgiven. I became a new person. Now when I would like to forgive others and love them, but I realize that I have no time. Beloved church members, we are the ambassador for Christ. Do you feel hard to forgive others? I understand. Sometimes it seems impossible to forgive our friends, our parents, our spouse, our employers, in spite of this personality of ours. God gave us the mission of reconciliation. Let us consider Jesus Christ, who forgave our ugly, simple nature and died for us on the cross. The anger would destroy us if we hold it in our mind. Please relieve it if we have by forgiving others. Okay, one more thing. What time is it? 25? Okay. I'm making sure. Lastly, he has. Okay, third one. Thirdly, he has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Committed. We have to deliver the word of his reconciliation. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19. Let's read it together. God has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Committed to us the word of reconciliation. Do you know why it's the word saver? Word saver is this. This is the bird-shaped big stickers which attach on the glasses of the building to save birds. Why does it need? A lot of birds, crashes of building glasses and die because they fly toward the trees and sky reflecting in the glasses, thinking it is beer. Understand that, right? Bird saber looks like an eagle or hawk, which is bird of prey. Little birds stop going in that way because they are afraid of those kind of birds. Many people in today's world is like a little birds. They are chasing illusion of reflecting images on the glasses. They try to fly to the trees or fly to the sky of money, high position, luxurious life reflected on the glasses of media or advertisement. We knew that everything we pursue in Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Satisfaction of life, love and true fellowship, wisdom and knowledge, intimate relationship, and everlasting life, happiness, and so on and so on. God has committed to us the word of reconciliations because we have all these things. As an ambassador for Christ, we have to tell others what is true, what is fear, what is life, what is happiness, and what is the way for all of them. We needed to introduce Jesus Christ, who is the word of reconciliation. We are an ambassador of Christ. Please remember that we needed to be reconciled with God first, and we should carry out the mission of reconciliation and deliver the message of reconciliation as an ambassador for Him. I pray that may Holy Spirit strengthen you, strengthen us, give us abundant blessing, and guide our life as we try our best to live a life of God's ambassador. God bless you. Thank you.
Amen.